Hello guys, welcome to Achieve IS. My name is Ayush Methi. In this video, we are going to talk about India-Nepal relations, which are going through very sensitive phase. And as we all know that recent statements by KP Ohli also intensifying these issues, which are very sensitive to our relations. India-Nepal relations, before going to further discuss this topic, I would like to answer a question, which is that why Nepal did not become the part of India after the independence of 1947. When India got independence in 1947, government of Nepal decided that it will not join Indian Union because they have their own cultural identity and they will continue their tradition of independence, which was since ancient times. Indians also respected Nepal's sovereignty. So that is why Nepal did not become the part of Indian Union. Now, India and Nepal still have a deeper historical ties. As we all know that Nepal is an important neighbor of India. Nepal occupies a special significance in our foreign policy because India and Nepal have geographical, historical, cultural and economic linkages. We also share ties in terms of Hinduism and Buddhism. As we all know that Buddha's birthplace Lumbini is located in present-day Nepal. Recently, Prime Minister also coined the term of Roti Beti Ka Rishta. When we discuss about India-Nepal relations, India-Nepal Treaty of Peace and Friendship of 1950 becomes very important because it forms the bedrock of special relations that exist between India and Nepal over the years. Let's discuss about Treaty of Peace and Friendship of 1950, which is very important for your prelims also. This treaty talks about reciprocal treatment of Indian and Nepali citizens, which means that Nepalese can move in the Indian territory without any hindrances and Indians can freely move in the Nepal territory without any hindrances. This treaty talks about reciprocal treatment of Indian and Nepali citizens in the two countries, in the matters of residence, property, business, movement. Simultaneously, it also established a national treatment for both Indian and Nepalese businesses. That means that once Nepalese goods entered into India's market, it will not be treated differently than domestic goods. It will be treated as the domestic goods. Okay. And one of the most important aspect of Treaty of Peace and Friendship of 1950 is that it also gives Nepal's access to weaponry from India. So please remember the Treaty of Peace and Friendship of 1950 because it's very important for UPSC, prelims and mains also. When we talk about the geographical ties, then we should know in Nepal shares border with 5 Indian states: Uttarakhand, UP, West Bengal, Sikkim and Bihar. And that's why it becomes an important point of cultural and economic exchange. Many rivers originate in Nepal. It feed perennial river system of India that helps in terms of ecology and hydropower potential. There are also many Hindu and Buddhist religious sites in Nepal, making it an important pilgrim site for large number of Indians. So we have some areas of cooperation: trade and economy, connectivity, military ties. Let us discuss them one by one. First of all, there is trade and economy. India is Nepal's largest trade partner. I repeat, India is Nepal's largest trade partner and the largest source of foreign investments. Indian firms engage in Nepal in areas of manufacturing, services, ports, dry port, insurance, banking, power sector, tourism, etc., etc. When we talk about connectivity, we all know that Nepal have the disadvantage of being a landlocked country. It is surrounded by India from 3 sides and it is open towards from one side towards Tibet. So India is helping Nepal टू ओवरकम इट्स डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ बीइंग अ लैंडलॉक कंट्री. हाउ? इंडिया इज डूइंग दिस बाय undertaking various connectivity programs to enhance people to people linkages and promote economic growth. Various memorandum of understandings, which you call MOUs, have been signed between both the governments for laying electric rail track, which is linking Kathmandu with Raxaul in India. We are also looking to develop inland waterways for the movement of cargo. Now, when we talk about development assistance, Government of India provides development assistance to Nepal by focusing on creation of infrastructure at the grassroots level. We provide development assistance to Nepal in areas of infrastructure, health, water resources, and etc. The one of the most important area of cooperation between India and Nepal is military. Defense cooperation. Bilateral defense cooperation includes assistance to Nepalese army. We provide equipment training to Nepalese army. As we all know that we have Gorkha regiments of the Indian army, in which the soldiers are recruited from the hill districts of Nepal. Gorkhas, which are born in the hill districts of Nepal, have amazing capability to combat in the hilly areas of border. So India from 2011 undertakes joint military exercise with Nepal, which is known as Surya Kiran. Surya Kiran is the military exercise between India and Nepal. Cultural ties. Let us talk about cultural ties. There have been initiatives to promote people-to-people contacts in the area of art and culture, academics, media. One of the most important agreements between India and Nepal is the Three Sister City Agreement, in which we are connecting Kathmandu to Varanasi, Lumbini to Bodh Gaya, and Janakpur to Ayodhya. Recently, another issue is coming up of Janakpur and Ayodhya. A recent statement by Nepalese Prime Minister KP Oli that Lord Ram was born in Nepal and not in India. So that's another issue. We will discuss about it in another video. Let us move further. Humanitarian assistance. Nepal lies in very sensitive ecological fragile zone. Nepal faces many earthquakes, floods, which causes massive damage to both life and money in Nepal. So it remains Nepal remains the biggest recipient of India's humanitarian assistance. Indian community. Huge number of Indians live in Nepal and huge numbers of Nepal live in India. This includes businessmen, traders, doctors, engineers, workers, etc., etc. When we talk about multilateral partnership, we all know that India and Nepal share multilateral forums like BBIN, BIMSTEC, SAARC, NAM. We share multiple forums with Nepal. Now, as we have discussed before the starting of the video, that there are many challenges between India and Nepal, and one of the most critical challenge between India and Nepal is the Indo-Nepal border, which is virtually open, lightly policed. That's why it is exploited by terrorist outfits and insurgent groups from northeastern part of India. Terrorist outfits or terrorist groups supply trained cadres fake Indian currency into India. We are observing that trust deficit has also widened because Indian reputation of delaying implementation of various projects. One of the most important cause of the Indian Nepalese recent turmoil is that Nepal over the years has witnessed chronic political instability, which included a 10-year violent insurgency which damaged Nepal's development economy. So Nepal has also its own challenges. There also an anti-India feeling is rising among certain ethnic groups in Nepal. They think that India interferes too much in the Nepal's politics and it attacks India, attacks on the political sovereignty of Nepal. So Nepal is also tilting towards China. That is one of the most important challenge in India and Nepal relations. Now, as we have discussed about the cultural economic ties and recent challenges, let us talk about solutions, way forward, as we call it. First of all, India should not interfere in the politics of Nepal. We should refrain from interfering in the political sovereignty of Nepal. We all know that both the countries are affected due to misuse of open border. So we need to cooperate in those areas which will benefit the both countries. Like we have untapped resources of hydropower. We can cooperate in hydropower sector. India also should provide an alternate solution for India-Nepal ties so that our long people-to-people ties and cultural connect are maintained. So the final conclusion is that stable and secure Nepal is one requisite which India can't afford to overlook. Guys, this was the audio podcast. Thank you. Goodbye.